Residents from Ranchera village are still in shock following the death of four people from one family who were hacked to death by a fellow family member.
Thank you, Mr. Atwine. As a community, we don't have the right information because the killer himself was killed before he said anything. So we are only guessing. But majorly, these are traumatic situations. Someone having some problems in the mindset and does not share the problems with a friend or a religious leader.
The deceased include Tudiahewa Gladys, 42 years old, Nemanya Anita, 18 years old, who had completed senior four, Ainimani Susan, 16 years of age, and Atusasile Ernest, 9 years old. And these after being hacked, residents also revenged on the killer and murdered him in cold blood. I received a phone call from a resident informing me that people had been hacked to death. I was told that one family member invaded his relative's house and killed a number of people, and then the residents also killed him. I called police to intervene. I didn't know he could do such an act because I didn't expect him to kill his relatives and also my daughter, who had completed senior four. I don't know how to live with this. I hope God comforts me. Leaders have condemned the act and urged people to always report any misunderstandings to the authorities.
We don't know whether he was abusing drugs. We don't know whether he was schizophrenic. We don't know whether they had personal grudges, because in the process of rescuing the family members who were killed, the residents also had to harm him, so he has also died. So we shall keep with questions without answers.
We are burying four people from the same family, but the father is remaining with a younger kid. I don't know if the kid was still breastfeeding. But again, what I can tell the community is to avoid these growing regions every day and night.
The Rwenzori Region Police spokesperson confirmed the incident, noting that investigations into the matter are still ongoing.
We would have found out what was the motive of these people. But primary find out that they had issues with their family problems, and they were accusing each other of witchcraft, which is not the solution. Killing is not the solution. So we're appealing to the people to stop killing each other in the name of mob action or killing for revenge. And as police, we reached our scene, and today morning, our teams headed by DPC, because this happened in the night in Nkoma, that is in Kataliba Town Council. Police reached there in the night to secure the place or preserve the scene. DPC homicide team and CID team from the district reached there, and they picked the samples. These bodies were taken to Rukunyu Hospital for post-mortem, and also had a community engagement to change the mindset of the people.
The bodies of the deceased were taken to Ramaja Health Center 3 for post-mortem, and they were later taken back for burial. Report compiled by Anthony Atwine for the news.